Hi, everyone. I'm really happy today. I'm joined by my colleague, Dan Boerner. Prior to Apollo, Dan helped the Expedia Group build their graph platform. So Dan, we're just starting the new year. So where's the graph going in 2022?
The companies in the community that I talk to are not only well along adopting GraphQL, they're rethinking their businesses around a graph, a unified graph. And that's a big shift from years past.
So, I mean, how does it affect sort of your front end and your back end teams and the way in which they interact?
Right. In a traditional sort of REST API world that I've worked with and talked to others about, you've got this very sort of linear process. There's an individual client team or an app or an endpoint third-party API and some product manager wants to improve it and requests a feature, and the developer and then reaches out to try to find which endpoint that service from, which team to talk to. They have to talk to a back-end program manager or a product manager to schedule and prioritize that work. Then the developer has to do that work. And that's just a lot of coordination. The front-end teams are waiting around for that to roll out. Maybe their new version of the API has to be built. The service team, isn't always free to do that work. Maybe they're in the middle of some other priority. So it's super synchronous and it's sequential. And whereas in the graph model, you kind of can decouple the publishing of data with the consumption. And that means that a lot of different teams can make their own enhancements and grab that data without having to synchronize with each other. That means more things are happening at the same time.
Yeah.
Right. And that means they're happening in parallel. And that really matters for large groups with lots of APIs. And I think it leads to most of the developer experience benefits.
I want to dive in a little bit into sort of the aspect of how the graph impacts front-end developers, the consumers of the graph.
You just radically simplify the ability to get the data you need to build the experiences, right? I mean, you're just not searching for an endpoint, trying to coordinate with that team, trying to learn the specifics of that syntax or that calling scheme and what the error handling is. You're just trying to create a query to fetch the data, and then you can start using it. So this enormous lift you get from not having to do all that per endpoint and per service work. I think we forget that front-end developers, they join companies because they really are passionate about developing, customer experiences. And then too often, they realize their job isn't really about building customer experiences very much. It's about chasing down API endpoints, understanding error handling. It's just really frustrating, and they can't focus on what they really want to focus on. And I've talked to a bunch of front-end developers that they've just left companies because it's just not fun. And they want to go try to work on something that stretches their skills, not just a bunch of data mapping and API calls.
And what about the service teams, back-end teams? What metrics do you use to measure, their success with the graph?
If you've got all these REST endpoints and they're all versioned, you're just managing all these clients, right? And when you want to make a change, guess what you have to do? You might make a new version, and then you've got to convince a bunch of client teams to get off the old and migrate to the new. And if you can't get that last team off, you can't retire that. Similarly, if you want to make an architectural change, it almost always, you don't have a typed API. You don't exactly know how all your users, your customers, consumers of that API are using the fields. You don't even know which fields in a REST case that they're actually using. You return this giant payload. In the case of the graph, you actually can measure those things. So I think that the metrics you ought to be looking for on the service side are, how much you can free up service teams from having to manage all those versions and endpoints and doing jobs that they really have to do with client management, if you will, rather than actually trying to improve, say, the performance of their data or the modeling of their data. So I think that then frees up more time. So what does that mean? Performance should start to go up, right? They can optimize and spend their time on performance, or they can re-architect safely behind a typed contract. So for service teams, I think you're just looking, they have similar sort of, I think, qualitative happiness quotients that should go up. But additionally, just more capabilities should start coming out of that team because they're just not servicing as much debt.
Dan, well, thanks so much. It's always fun chatting.
Yeah. Thanks, everybody.